Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of the Heavy Hour Podcast. I'll admit the last one was a bit rushed. The last one wasn't really that planned or planned outright. So I might as well let this episode make up for it. Doesn't look like we have a huge chat here or even anyone in my chat. But you know what? That's fine. This is going on YouTube at the end of the day. So, of course, many people within the heavy community will definitely remember, I should probably move this up here, will definitely remember a few old heavy communities, heavy sub-communities, some old leagues. Yeah. One of these leagues is the National Heavy Boxing League. And not that many heavy mains actually know about the National Heavy Boxing League, unfortunately. Only the really experienced ones will have at least even recognized the name. Of course, we have someone here with us who is a veteran of the National Heavy Boxing League, and someone who has had many, many hours fighting to win the grand prize of a few seasons of the National Heavy Boxing League, only coming into one of the finals. Please welcome with us today, we have SpaceVegemite. How's it going, SpaceVegemite?
I just downed a whole can of energy drinks, so I'm ready to do this.
All right. Well, glad you have the energy to make up for it. So, welcome to the Heavy Hour Podcast. Of course, we should probably start out. Just give a bit of an introduction about yourself. You don't have to go too personal. Just be a bit general.
Yeah, well, I mean, I guess you've already done it yourself. Hi, I'm SpaceVegemite. Probably the greatest heavy to ever exist. Lol, rub my ego. That's my ego inflation for the interview. I'm collector of bananas, puncher of bitches. Just standard stuff.
Yeah, tell us about the banana collection you've started.
Yeah, so basically I've wanted to create like a huge banana shortage in the TF2 community, or like whatever's left of it after the closet cheaters came in. I have over 2,000, and I'm not giving them away unless you give me a Burning Flames team captain. Ooh. So that's that.
Oh, you are quite committed. Right, so we're going to start with just about a couple questions. These are usually prerequisite questions that I ask before we get into the nitty-gritty. So, firstly, how many hours do you have on Heavy, and how long have you been playing the Heavy class?
If you were to look at my hours on Heavy, you'd think that, oh, I just have, like, about 1,000 hours, but in reality, I have, like, about 1,700, maybe 1,800. I reset my stats, so... It's kind of iffy, but somewhere in between 1,500 to 2,000.
Okay.
So, yeah.
How long have you been playing the Heavy class?
If you were looking at my mercenary badge, you'd think I started in 2018, but I started playing the game on the Orange Box for Xbox 360. And Heavy was actually the first class I wanted to main. So... Right. I guess you could say I've been a heavy main throughout the whole of the time I've been playing TF2, but it's the class has changed quite a bit.
Ah, so you're a veteran. All right, I was unaware of that.
I guess.
Yeah, well, for lack of a better term. What is your standard heavy weapon loadout?
I'm looking for all the questions like you usually do, and I'm thinking, what weapons do I use? Because you'd think I'd, like, be a minigun or Tomislav lover, but I'm probably going to go with the Hua Long Heater. Because, like, it's a unique minigun, and I don't think a lot of heavies have really brought out the potential that it has. Like, the whole flanking playstyle with the fire and, like, how it can help... Like how friendly pyros on your team can help you do more damage with it. It's like it's like the brass beast, but you actually get to move.
Okay. The brass beast, but you can only get to move. Is it possible you can elaborate on that? That's a very interesting mindset for the Hulong.
Yeah, with the brass beast, like that movement speed on like when you're revved up, that plays a bigger factor than you realize. Like, it's so slow, it makes once you go back to the minigun, you feel fast as the heavy. I think there's like some real untapped potential, like with the whole damage boost you get from fire.
Oh, alright.
I think it's a pretty neat mechanic.
I agree. I used to use the Huon Heater a lot back then when I actually started playing heavy. Okay, what is your highest kill streak and average amount of kills per game with or without a pocket medic?
Without a pocket medic, I can get godlikes frequently. It's been a bit of a struggle lately since like all the sniper mains have been coming out the closet. Energy drinks really coming through. Yeah, like if there's no good snipers, I can get godlikes, maybe like 30 kill streak if I try without a medic. With a medic, I'm considering I'm a heavy main. I don't like having a pocket medic on me. I want to get my gains naturally instead of just like having someone behind me like artificially boosting my strength. Like, if you know what I mean, like,
yeah.
I like doing stuff by myself. I'm like a lone heavy, which is, like, going back to the weapon loadout, is why I've been using the second banana a lot, because I just prefer being a solo heavy, paired with the Fist of Steel.
Okay, alright. That's a pretty cool mindset to have. I should probably adopt that mindset sooner or later, although I do play alone sometimes. I've been playing alone recently. Usually without artificial boosting. Alright, so let's get into the nitty-gritty now. So, take me through an extended journey, or take me through an extended story of your journey as a heavy main, why you chose to play heavy, your major accomplishments, obstacles and setbacks, and how you got to where you are today.
So, I began, I guess, like, around 2014, when I was, like, browsing through YouTube, as you do as a little tiny brainlet child, and I stumble across a video called Top 9 Weapons in Team Fortress 2 by Forful's Minion, and I'm thinking to myself, oh, this is such a good video, like, Team Fortress 2, that looks like such a good game, and I decide to get it on the Orange Box on the 360, where you have Half-Life 2, both Parts 1 and 2, you have Portal and Team Fortress 2, of course. And I'm thinking, oh, I'll be able to get to try all these weapons until, like, evidently it's just a shitty 2007 version with, like, no weapons to speak of. And fast forward to 2018, finally getting to use those weapons. And, yeah, I guess I've just been, like, interested in all of Heavy's weapons and, like, the different amount of benefits that they can provide. And honestly, I haven't been a heavy main all the time. I've had this, like, kind of identity crisis. Like, thinking about, oh, what class am I going to main? Like, what fits my playstyle? And I've noticed pretty, like, into the middle of it all, the tank class is my go-to playstyle. So I just decided I'm going to stick as the heavy. And, yeah, that's pretty much how I just started maining heavy. I tried everything else, from scout, soldier, I even tried medic with, like, 10 hours under my belt. And it wasn't a good time. And, yeah, I guess, like, heavy's, like, an easy-to-play, hard-to-master kind of class. That's what I like. I like a challenge.
Okay. That's a good mindset. I know you're actually pretty well known in the heavy boxing community. Can you tell us a bit about your time being in the National Heavy Boxing League?
The Heavy Boxing League, yeah, so usually, like, when it was still around from, like, oh, I don't know, as far back as, like, 2012 to 2021, 2022, the National Heavy Boxing League was essentially, like, a huge gathering of people competing in heavy boxing tournaments, usually stuff like the Killing Gloves of Boxing or the Stock Fist, in it, and you just fight through a bracket for keys, and eventually I got so good that I started being featured on their Twitch channel, and I won a decent amount. I won two tournaments in my first season, and that was the only season I participated in because I ended up getting burnt out. But I was actually number one ranked on the Glicker rankings for heavy boxing, so in a literal sense, I was the best in the world at heavy boxing, and I can proudly take that to my grave.
Ooh, that is quite an accomplishment. There are a few that I've seen recently sort of outshine it, but I'm not going to, of course, bring you down in that sense.
Yeah, yeah, I'm way past my prime. Like, I'm rusty as hell. I haven't trained in about a few years.
All right. Okay, next question. What can be changed about the heavy class?
There's two things I want to go into. First of all, is like heavy as like a general class, like stuff that I think could be changed to his movement. And then the second bit I want to go into is weapons, because like I feel like those are two completely different problems that the heavy has, both like as sort of movement and weapons. So yeah, I think the heavy could use some kind of like, I don't know, but if you try to like buff the heavy in any way, I feel like he'd be too broken, like as a fundamental class. Well, something I do want to see changed about it, and it technically goes with the miniguns, but when you're revved up and you start firing, there is a damage penalty and accuracy penalty that comes with firing, so which is why you usually see heavy mains pre-fire around corners and stuff, because there's the damage and accuracy penalty. Mm-hmm. And I think that we're past the point where that doesn't need to be a thing anymore, so I'd love to see that removed, like, on heavy.
Hmm. Okay. I remember one of our previous interviewees talked a bit about this. Are there any other changes that you would recommend for the heavy class?
This is where I get into the weapons. There's two miniguns that I think don't, like, how can I put this in, like, I don't think they're, like, up to snuff with the minigun and Tommy Slav, and I think, like, changing them could be something that, like, finally gives these two, like, a chance to shine. First of all is the Natasha, and I very famously do not like the Natasha. I think it's a brain-dead weapon, second least favorite weapon behind the Huntsman. But I'd love to see the slowdown mechanic, because I think that's where heavy is seen as, like, an easy class, just being able to slow down people, easy tracking. I'd love to see a complete rework where the slowdown on hit gets changed to heal on hit, as, like, make heavy a sustain tank, kind of like as you see in different kinds of game genres, like MOBAs, for example, like multiplayer online battle arenas and stuff. Just let him deal damage and heal at the same time, not to, like, an insane degree where pairing him with a pocket medic's busted, but, like, just enough so, like, it's on par with the minigun, while also having its downsides, like a slower rev, for example.
Ah, so a bit similar to the Bloodsauger for medic.
Yeah, in a way, except, like, make the healing not anywhere near as close, I guess.
Mm.
Just kind of, like, tone it down, maybe, like, 2 or 3 health a hit.
Hmm. That's an interesting concept.
That was, like, one of the old, like, prototype miniguns, I think. They wanted to add, like, when they were thinking about weapons.
Mm. Is it still in the workshop? That seems like a concept.
I'm not sure. Like, I think it was, like, a really old concept back in, like, 2008, 2009.
Oh, okay, so it's that old.
Hmm. So, like, yeah, that's, like, a genuine change, and I think, like, there's another weapon that I want to change, and, like, I know I've sung my praises about it, but the Hulong heater, I'd love to change it, since, like, all of Heavy's miniguns are, like, bullet-based weapons, so I was thinking about giving Heavy a fireball cannon, because I think that'd be great, just having the fireballs come out of a dragon's mouth.
Oh, like the aircraft carrier from TFC.
Or yeah, I remember seeing in a previous episode, you talked about the aircraft cannon, but I think this would work, like, a projectile-based weapon instead of, like, bullet. Because the aircraft cannons are bullet-based, with an explosion when someone gets hit. I'm thinking, like, maybe a charge-up on it, so you can, like, charge up the fireball and it grows bigger and, like, does big splash damage.
Oh, so like the cow mangler.
Yeah, I guess, except... Yeah, I guess it is like the cow mangler, but, like, even make it so you can, like, keep pumping out fireballs without it feeling broken, I guess. Like, that's, like, a very vague term. I guess, like, a slower firing speed. Or, like, make the fireballs, like, a lot weaker. Something akin to, like, the Dragon's Fury, perhaps.
Hmm. Okay. I like that. That's actually a pretty good concept. I think I should probably draw a connection to that one weapon concept that Big Joey made about, I'd say, a couple years back with the laser cannon, that laser minigun. It definitely reminds me of that. The one that you're talking about, of course.
Yeah.
Okay. This is a good question. This is actually one that was requested pretty recently. Heavy mains that have inspired you, if there are any, and heavy mains YouTubers and videos that you would recommend for others to watch that you see are the best source for help to improve your skill level as heavy.
Heavy mains that have inspired me. Me.
Okay.
Me. No, all jokes aside, throw an ego out the door. I think, like, all the heavy YouTubers that, like, give tips about, like, positioning or ways to deal with, like, any kind of class matchups that you might find in, like, a one-on-one scenario. As much as I really don't want to say, like, oh yeah, I recommend this guy, Big Joey, I have to say it, like, biggest heavy main YouTuber the community has. Mm-hmm. Like, yeah, and, like, some of the stuff he says I don't agree with, but, like, just go check it out. It's, like, there's some, like, really helpful stuff. Like, there's a video where it goes over all the, like, the little tips and tricks you can do on certain maps, like Dust Bowl, for example. I remember that video. Hmm. Which actually, taught me, like, how to, like, it was on the second point of Dust Bowl. There's, like, where the huge-ass building is, like, behind it's the point, there's, like, this, wood panel that you can jump on, like, if you crouch, jump up it, and you can get onto the second floor for, like, no issue.
Ooh. Okay.
So, like, you learn stuff for YouTube kids. Not YouTube kids, but YouTube, you get the idea, but...
From YouTube kids.
What a joke. Kind of like Big Joey himself. Wow, shade.
Why do I say it? I've been a huge critic of Big Joey. As you can see in the chat, there is someone there, hello Sodium, who is also a critic of Big Joey. I myself have been a critic of Big Joey in recent times as I've, you know, grown as a heavy main. There are some videos in fact, Big Joey, in my opinion, I wouldn't really put him at the top. I'd probably put him somewhere like past Bearded or even Rider Cycle. But yeah, he does make some pretty decent videos. He is very much, in some people's hearts, number one out there.
Yeah, there's other YouTubers, like you mentioned, Rider Cycle, and also, even though I'm not sure if he plays the game anymore, but there's a guy on YouTube, if you're looking to, like, get into heavy seriously, I recommend checking out Rondago's old stuff.
There's also another guy named Musique. He was known in Heavy Warriors a lot. He was a multi-platinum heavy, getting first place, like, I think, 3 or 4 times in UGC Highlander.
Yeah, I've seen him around I saw him around the National Heavy Boxing League quite a fair bit.
Yeah.
For, like, promoting that.
Ah, alright. Are there any other heavy mains that you would recommend?
Like, I'm not sure, honestly. I don't think there's a whole lot to pick from.
You don't need to spout names or just a random name that comes out of your ass. Just think about it for a bit. If there are none, then I'll move on.
Right, yeah, I can't think of anything. Let's just move on.
All right. Okay, so, of course, we're nearing the end. This was quite a long interview, but I liked it. What are some tidbits of advice that you would give to those that are either struggling or new to heavy? And what are some maps and strategies that you would recommend?
Get good.
That's very vague.
Wow. Okay, in order to get good, you don't be bad.
That's also very vague.
Like, seriously, I think the big takeaway, like, from playing heavy is that positioning is everything. It's quite a difference when you're in... Like, positioning just matters a lot. I can't exactly think of, like, examples, but where you position yourself, like, for example, if you're out in the open, yeah, you're gonna die. Get good. But I think it's better to, like, play to heavy strengths and, like, minimize the weaknesses as much as possible, like slow movement speed or people dangling over you, like playing scout, jumping over you. Like, just getting, like, tight, close areas that you can easily mow down people without much of a fuss. It's like, yeah, stay close quarters, like, where the heavy should be, a close quarters class.
You want to give to those struggling or new, like, maybe just small little, you know, bits of advice?
I guess, like, practice tracking, I want to say. Like, tracking is just the big, like, main thing about heavy. You got to learn how to do that, and if you don't, you're going to fail. You're not there to, like, get good at all the heavy stuff. Because, like, at a higher level, people are not afraid to exploit your weaknesses, so just minimize them as much as possible. You can't cover every base, but just minimize it as much as you can.
Yeah, you can basically just cover all the more important bases. There's always going to be, like, yeah, a small margin of error.
Hey, sniper, JFK me! Oh. Like, yeah, I mean, sure, it'll get you a pocket medic, but it won't stop the sniper rifle hitting you in the head, so.
Yeah. Alright, that's fair enough.
Yeah, that's about all I can give, really. I'm not a big tip guy, honestly.
I mean, you know,
I just tell you to get good and send you off.
Okay, well, I'll say thanks for coming on. We just have two more questions.
Every single heavy main's going to tell you, listen to Rock, listen to Doom, listen to something like the heaviest shit you can find in like the 1990s garage band stuff. But honestly, if you want like good music, I suggest getting off the computer and listening to artists, like actual music composers. Just kidding, like, all modern music sucks. If I did have to pick video game music, listen to the chill stuff, actually. Like, that usually calms you down, because heavy, very angry class, good, listen to metal. At the end of the day, like, all you gotta do is chill, which, I say that, but I can't take my own advice, so... Whoops.
Fair enough.
And... Or if you wanna be a Soundsmith fan, just listen to the song... Like Mania or Diddy Kong Racing OST, as you do.
Alright, that's fair. And I know you sort of did answer this before, but the nitty-gritty question, the $1 million question that has been bamboozling heavy mains minds ever since Big Joey had to make a two-part series about it. Tomislav or the stock minigun?
Base jumper.
That is a good exception. Okay.
For real though, all rolling in its coffin.
You know what? That's actually kind of understandable.
Fuck it. Let's go, Tomislav.
Okay. All right. Well, guess your technical space. All right, ladies and gentlemen, this was the Heavy Hour Podcast. I'm DJ Gorilla Jones, our interviewee here, Space Vegemite. Thank you for coming on to the show, Space Vegemite.
Banana King.
All right. I'll send you on your way. Yeah, thanks for coming on, man.
I get vanilla butter bean.
All right, that was something. Space, thank you for coming on to the show. I absolutely appreciate it. That was, dude, this is going to be a long video. But you know what? That's the whole best part about it. All right, let me check for now. For now, we're going to go to just a short break. Well, actually, no, I'm going to ramble on for just a bit. I'm going to keep this slideshow on. Thank you all for coming. All right. So I was supposed to do an interview with Francium next. You guys might know who Francium is. Sodium, I think you might know who he is. He's in the Heavy Warriors. He's one of the OGs of the Heavy Warriors as well. Wonkeater. Thank you, Space. Alright, let's see if he is around. Okay. Balls, breast beast. Okay, yeah. Thank you. Thank you to that guy with that name I can't even pronounce in any way, shape, or form. Right. In the meantime,